Publon is nothing but it is used to track your publications, citation matrices, and peer review. And it is a journal working work in a single and easily to maintain the profile. So it is a profile system which has all the sorts of things. You can track your publication, citation matrix, peer review, and journal editing work in a single profile. All your publication will be instantly imported from the Web of Science or KID and your bibliographic references manager. It is a trusted citation matrix for Web of Sciences, which collects the unique researcher IDs collected with the help of this. And you can verify your peer review and journal editing service with the help of Publon. And the most important thing nowadays, you can endorse the journal for the more indexing of the journal, which is beneficial for the journal itself as well as your sake of academic career. So you should go for the Publon, register for the Publon, and then endorse the journal as per specified category. ORCID, the differences between the ORCID and Publon is nothing but it is a organization run by the ORCID community. Publon is run by the author itself. So it is registered. First step is register for the ORCID with the help of your mail or institutional mail. Then add the relevant detail of this. We can go for the login and password. We can confirm it. And then add your visibility with the help of publication should be added automatically. You can link your publication with the help of Scopus, or you can add work with the help of manual counts such as DOI, PubMed IDs, and other identifiers. So we can add manually also in this. We can add it and then link with the Scopus. Is the most important thing with your publication on Scopus. So Scopus is a larger indexing database, so it is more useful for the author to directly link from the Scopus to ORCID. And then add the relevant details such as qualification, publication, and review membership award and grant research proposal. So this is the difference between ORCID and Publon. So ORCID, it is a institute login with the help of mail or institution mail, but ORCID ID is nothing but very important unique ID given to the open researcher ID. So nowadays, just like your Aadhaar card, it is most important for the academic researchers with the unique ID. The biggest advantage, you can use this ORCID ID for your publication, journal, grant, and all these things while giving you for the journal as well as for the review work. It is more important for the editors because most of the time in India, there are the problem of the similar name, Sumit Sharma. There are the N number of doctors as Sumit Sharma. So unique ID is provided with the help of ORCID. So it is your identity for the publication. That is, no one can confuse with your similar identity. So this is the biggest advantage of ORCID. So now we can go for some sort of 5 minutes for the online demo of Publon and ORCID. So these are my references. So this is a journal on the Google. We go for the Publon.com. After this Publon, there is a column KMAT directly. I am already logged in here. So it is KMAT directly. So before that, we have to log in as by your ID. We have to register first. After registration, you will go for this column. And this is the dashboard came. So this is my dashboard itself after login with the register. And the biggest advantage, you can login the Publon with the help of Gmail also, as well as the ORCID ID also. I login with the help of my ORCID ID, and the unique ID is automatically created. That is Web of Science. This is the unique ID created with the help of Web of Science. These are my publication taken by the ORCID itself. I have 110, but I am not edited it, but they are the 47 publications seen. This is my H index, verified reviews are 19. So this is a summary of the dashboard, and you can update all the things here, and you can take the publication from your ORCID ID itself. So we can link this. This is my publication. All the publication came here from the Web of Sciences or researcher ID. These are the peer review history which is taken, and with the help of this, we can go for next time. But the most important thing is these are the matrices for the authors. They can see your daily progress or monthly or yearly progress, that is how much time you are cited, or what about the publication, all these things. The most important thing in the Publon is we should go for the journals. So nowadays it is most important when we go for the publisher, that is when we type IP Innovative Journal, there are the, I think there are the 48 results came, and out of this 48, we can see the verified reviews of International Indian Journal of Clinical Anesthesia, that is by the IP. And then the author, researcher, editor, all the researchers should endorse the journal first. This is the most important thing nowadays. So after this review, 99 reviews are there. Gupta sir is there, top handling editor on the Publon. And then we have to endorse the journal. I think it is already endorsed by me. So you can endorse the journal. So we go for the next journal. So this is the method by which we can endorse the journal. So all innovative journals now on the Publon, that is the biggest advantage, and this is the hard work of the innovative or ISRF team that we can see nowadays. All the journals are endorsed with the Publon, and our work or researcher work now to endorse these journals so that we are benefited with the indexing as per specified. So this is the column. This is only two endorsements for the journal. So we must endorse the journal. Immediately we received the message that journal is successfully endorsed. This is the simple thing. We have to go for the journal endorsement, and it is beneficial for the authors as well as the editor as well as the journal. So it is most important thing nowadays as per the Publon specified. Publon is basically for the journal endorsement, mainly for the peer review, and you can, as the editor, you can edit also. So this is the advantage of your Publon. Now we go for the ORCID. So this is ORCID login. You can log in with the help of your ID first. So you can first register for the ORCID. That is the most important thing. This is a simple step. So in the first page itself, it shows it is a three-step process only. In the home page, it is just distinguish yourself from your easiest three steps are there. First is you have to register for the ORCID, then update your data. It is free, it just only take few minutes for the registration. Then you got the login ID and password. Then you can promptly add your publication with the help of linking with the Scopus and add your relevant detail and share your ORCID ID to everyone or where it is required most of the time. So most important thing it is. So we go for the sign in now. After signing, you will directly go for the dashboard, and in the dashboard you can see the updated details of, this is my login, so it is obviously seen. It is this is your unique 16 number ID is there, 004 times. This is the 16 number digital academic ID, I say as your Aadhaar card. So it is unique number assigned to your name, and it is always linked with your publication. So it is beneficial for the author as well as for the journal as well as for the publication For there are n number of advantages of the orchid, but mainly you have to first register, then use it. Then you can know the beneficial effects of this orchid. This is my name. This is editor bibliography. Whatever you can edit. These are my employment. Previous work is done. This is my education, MBBS, and after that MD. Invited position from the IP Archives of Cytology and Histopathology Research, and then funding, and then work. The most important thing is work. So you can add the publication. You can add the publication. You can add the work here. So there are the links given, search and link. With the help of DOI, you can add. If your article has a DOI, you can add directly here with the help of DOI. If you have PubMed ID, then you can add it with the help of PubMed ID. Or if you have a BibTeX file, that means your bibliographic indexes, you can write your n number of publication in BibTeX file. You can upload here with the help of this, or you can add manually. So these are the four methods for adding the research for your ORCID ID. So these are the directly taken by the cross reference. So this is the latest guest in Microdioticlum published on this month, 2021. This is directly taken from the cross reference. These are the opportunistic infections. So these are directly taken, just you have to give the permission. We received a mail. These are from the Publon. So we received, or these are from the cross reference. These are directly taken. So we received a mail like this. In the inbox, we received a mail. Then required permission for that. And if you grant the permission, you record published handmade changes. This is the permission. Add your publication to your ORCID. So this is the hello. This is from the cross reference. This saw this article by your name. If you grant permission, the article is added automatically to your ORCID. So first, after adding the scopus, and they show the message that is authorized. You are successfully added. So we close this. And this is important for your adding the article. So this is the most important point for the authors for perspective. The authors are not very much confused regarding this addition of this article. So you can add by n number of ways. The most importantly by the manual, as well as linking the scopus cross reference and all these things. Thank you. So these are my references. These are the links which are used by